أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس، الحمد لله الفرج الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ثم أما بعد، my dear respected brother and sister Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Inshallah, we'll continue the value of the Quran as we start to deep a little bit in our holy book, the Quran. And subhanAllah, this book has so many values. Whatever we can get out, we will never ever finish it until the judgment day. And that's what Allah Azza wa Jal telling us about this Quran, how beautiful it is. But just need some people to make a little effort. وَلَقَدْ يَسَّرْنَا الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. Allah Azza wa Jal make the Quran very easy to read it, to understand it. It needs just people to make a little effort, and Allah Azza wa Jal will help. And subhanAllah, wallahi, my brothers and sisters, every time you read the Quran, you will enjoy it. You feel the sweetness of the book, of the word of Allah Azza wa Jal. We read Surah Yusuf so many times. You still read it till now and you enjoy the story. You read Surah Al-Kahf so many times. And when you read it again and again and again, you still enjoy it. SubhanAllah. Not like any other book. Any other book, if you read it one, twice, three, four, five times, it's more than enough. You cannot continue to read this book unless if you need some certain things out of this book to remember some things. That's it. But you cannot continue to read the whole book every time. But with the Quran, subhanAllah, you enjoy it every time you read it. And inside of this book, there is so many things. Today in the khutbah, I was talking about the day of judgment day, when people, they will read the books, and how much people, they're going to be between happiness and sadness. And the Quran, one of the value, he's telling us the secrets. He's telling us everything. He's telling us what is going to make you sad and what's going to make you happy. So it's very simple. By Allah Azza wa Jal, he guides us to take the way to make our life happy in the dunya and in the hereafter. The believer, he just needs to follow the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's all. Before the time will come and you cannot come back again. You cannot come again to fix whatever you left in this dunya. It's only one chance. That's why if people, they gamble, which is forbidden in Islam, but if somebody gambling, he's gambling with his money. You will never ever see people, they gambling with their life. Nobody can do that. If they do that, they're out of their mind, they have nothing to lose, like they got different things. But normal people, when they gamble, they're looking for something better. They're looking to become rich. They're looking to become more power. That's all what they're looking for. So not everybody can gamble with his life. He can gamble with the money. If he lose the money, it's no big deal. I can make more money. If I lose my house, I can buy another house. If it doesn't matter. You got a car outside, BAU 34R. Toyota. So if you, brother, please, if it belongs to anybody, just please move it so the other brother can leave, inshallah.
BUA 34R.
Toyota, somebody please just move it quickly. Maybe any of the sister, please, if your car outside, please move it.
BUA 34R.
Yeah, somebody move already. Jazakumullah khair. Yes. So brother, Quran is giving you the way to be happy in this dunya and the hereafter. You just need to follow it. You just need to follow the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. It's very simple. And also Allah Azza wa Jal guide us. Who make us sad? Who make us sad? And who make us happy? The way of Allah Azza wa Jal, he make us happy. The way of the shaitan, he make us sad. That's why you're gonna see the shaitan. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned about him. And when he said, إِنَّمَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالسُّوءِ وَالْفَحْشَاءِ. الله عز وجل أسعى الذين يا أيها الناس كلوا من طيبات ما رزق ما مما في الأرض حلالا طيبا يا أيها الناس كلوا مما في الأرض حلالا طيبا ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان all people eat from whatever you have it's halal for you that's why the ulama said the majority of the things Allah عز وجل has created for us is halal the haram is certain things all the drink is halal only wine is haram anything take your mind away is haram all the food is halal except beef and if you eat something you eat animal or anything like that or something like being slaughtering is not in the halal way few things not halal but the rest is few things is not halal and the rest is halal for us and Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us don't follow the shaitan step by step because the shaitan when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that in the hadith he said the shaitan he come to the son of Adam and he tell him ukfur disbelieve in Allah he get you from the top things and the son of Adam he said no I believe in Allah Azza wa Jalla so he start take another step he go down so disbelieve in the prophets no disbelieve in the book no disbelieve in slowly slowly until he get you to make a small sin to show off he start with you with the first step if you agree with the shaitan for any step and you follow the next one he take you again as much as he can if he can get you back to the kufr he will do it that's why Allah Azza wa Jalla from the beginning don't follow his steps because it's going to take you step by step that's exactly after Nuh alayhi salam all of us know the story وقالوا لا تذرن آلهتكم ولا تذرن ودا ولا سواعا ولا يغوث ويعوق ونسرا five people in Nuh's time they used to follow Allah عز وجل follow Prophet Nuh after they die the shaitan take them in a journey way to can misguide them and all of us we know the story how we come first we're talking about these people how good they are how they used to follow Allah عز وجل and then the next generation He start tell them, I will make a statues for you. So when I tell you the story, you look at them, you remember. And then the next generation, you tell them, while I'm telling you the story, turn around them so you can remember everything. And the next generation, you tell them, that's your God. So he take them step by step. And that's the way of the shaitan all the time. And that's why Allah Jal warning us. And Allah Jal in this ayah said, إِنَّمَا يَأْمُرُكُمْ بِالسُّوءِ وَالْفَحْشَاءِ وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Three steps. That's why the ulama said, السوء, the ma'asiyah doesn't need had. Like people, they make sins. But it's no role, it's no slashing, or no anything, cutting hand. That's السوء. الفحشاء, the sin, well, there is a had for that. There is consequences for that. There is, if you steal, you're going to cut your hand. If you make zina, you're going to slash your back. All the things. And the person, subhanAllah, when he starts with a small ma'asiyah, he take him to the biggest one. And from the biggest one, when you come to tell him something, he start tell you, I know better than you. Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't ask to do that. Wallahi, we saw people, they come in the TV, they said, Allah never tell us there is hijab. Why woman should wear hijab? Where you get this from? Allah Azza wa Jalla tell us in the Quran, وَيَقُولُونَ وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ You're telling fake about Allah Azza wa Jalla. Telling Allah Azza wa Jalla never say anything about the hijab in the Quran. You start to get things, and the ayat is very clear in the Quran, but there is people they start saying, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he didn't ask not to wear hijab. Woman can do whatever she wants. It's her freedom. There is nothing in the Quran to talk about hijab. So that's how the shaitan take us step by step. First, small sin. You don't worry. If you do the things, nobody gonna slash your back. Nobody gonna cut your hand. Nobody, so it's no big deal. I can do it. I can ask Allah to forgive me after some time. Inshallah, he's gonna forgive me. So he's taking the first step, the small one. And then he come to you to al-fahsha. Drinking wine, zina wal-iyazu billah, gambling, stealing, killing, all the things. And if you come to tell him something, you don't wanna believe it, he start telling you, Allah Azza wa Jal, he tell me, this person, he doesn't deserve this money. I deserve it. I have to take it. And he start make himself the best one he know the religion. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he's telling us from the beginning, stay away from the step of the shaitan. Because he's going to take you until he let you fail in the trap and you cannot come out. So my brother in the judgment day, all of us will see our situation. And we'll see, after the people they believe the shaitan, Allah Azza wa Jalla tell us, when we read this ayah every time, وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعْدَ الْحَقِّ وَوَعَدْتُكُمْ فَأَخْلَفْتُكُمْ. A shaitan in the judgment day, he's gonna come to give a speech. Some people, when they hear this speech, they will feel very sad. Because the shaitan tell them, Allah has given you the true promise. If you follow his way, you're going to Jannah. But I lie to you and I tell you, if you disobey Allah and you follow me, you're gonna go to Jannah. You're not gonna find anything. After death, there is nothing. And you believe me. Or even some people, they know there is a hellfire and there is a heaven and everything. But the shaitan all with them tell them, delay it. Enjoy your life. Leave it for now. You still have time. You're still young. And even subhanAllah, if you become 70 years old, he still wish to live another 20 years. I know some people, they live until 90. I know some people, so maybe I will live more than that. So let me enjoy my life. So the shaitan will come in this day to give them a speech. This speech, my brothers and sisters, it will make the people very sad. The people, they believe the shaitan, the people, they follow the shaitan in this time, they will be very sad not to believe Allah Azza wa Jal and to believe the shaitan in this time. So imagine, wallahi, wallahi, if we come in this time and all what Allah Azza wa Jal has telling us in the Quran, do that, do that, do that, and the shaitan, he always tell you, do opposite. And you remember this time, I used to do opposite what Allah tells me. And now the shaitan is telling me very clear. وَمَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانٍ إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. I have no power. I have no authority to move you or to let you do the haram things. I just is to whispering in your ears, telling you do the haram. فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. Quickly. In Arabic, when you get the fa, it means somebody did it very quick. فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. You don't even take a time to think about it. You don't even sit with yourself to say it's halal or haram. You don't even match it with the Quran and the Sunnah. Quickly, فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي. Don't blame me. وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Blame yourself. What's going to happen in this day? مَا أَنَا بِمُصْرِخُكُمْ وَمَا أَنْتُمْ بِمُصْرِخِينَ. You cannot help me and I cannot help you. You see, the shaitan now, he's giving you away. He's giving you away. It's finished. You're going to the hellfire. I have nothing to do with you. I have nothing. I have no authority. I didn't come with gun in your head and I tell you to steal or to kill somebody or to rape somebody or to do haram. I never put gun in your head. I was just discussing things with you and you agreed. That's it. Blame yourself. Don't blame me. That's what the shaitan is going to do. So in this time, my brother, imagine when this one, you trust him in the dunya, he come to you in this time and he tell you, I have nothing to do. You cannot even help me. I cannot even help you. Leave me alone. Both of us will go to the hellfire. How much these people are going to feel sad? After they believe the shaitan and they believe the promise of the shaitan, Allah Azza wa Jalla, that's why in the Quran he said, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ. The shaitan, he was all the time before we born. Since Adam alayhi salam, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ. The shaitan be always your enemy. It's not only for today. Shaitan is not our enemy now. The shaitan is our enemy since you born. Since you born a little baby and you have an enemy. You did nothing since you come to the dunya and you have enemy. Can you believe it? إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا. Take him as an enemy as well. Be careful. Don't believe him. Your aduwa doesn't wish for you to be good. Actually, he wishes for you to be bad all the time. So how come you believe your aduwa? How come you believe your enemy? إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ كَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوًا فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًا إِنَّمَا يَدْعُوا حِزْبَهُ. He always calling his people, his follower, to go away. Allah Azza tell us, لِيَكُونُوا مِنْ أَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. To be the owner of the hellfire. To be in the hellfire. That's what he called his people, his follower. Like nobody, if you follow somebody, you wish him to guide you to better life, to better position, to better anything, better than what you are. That's why I'm following you. But the shaitan, yad'u, he's calling his follower to be what? To be the people of the hellfire. And that's what the people follow. But they don't understand what they follow. Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran, Ya Bani Adam, O son of Adam. And they call us the son of Adam to remind us what Shaitan did for our father Adam. إِنَّمَا لَا يَحْتِنُكُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Don't let the Shaitan make fitna on you, between you and your brother, between you and your wife, between you and Islam, between you and the religion. How will Allah? Allah said, كَمَا أَخْرَجَ أَبَوَيْكُمْ. As he take your fathers and mothers, Adam and Eve, Adam and Hawa, أَخْرَجُهُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. أَبَوَيْكُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ. You remember when they take your mom and your dad, Adam and Eve, out from Jannah, he wouldn't do the same thing with you. He wouldn't take you to the hellfire. So be careful of him. He's your enemy. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he's telling us to be careful. And the second thing, second sadness, it can happen to the people in the judgment day. When they come to a time and they find themselves, the holy book of Allah Azza wa Jal, the Quran, he's been neglected. He's on the roof in the houses, full of dust on top of this book. When Ramadan comes, some people they start to clean it and they start read it. But during the year, nobody remembers the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla. So when you come in a judgment day, as Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ. The Rasul, he's calling Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he said, إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. My people, they're neglecting the Quran. And in the Arabic things, when he said, إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ, different than to say, إِنَّ قَوْمِ هَجَرُوا الْقُرْآنَ. If somebody leaves something which he doesn't know it, he has no knowledge about it, that's why he doesn't care, he left it. But اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ, they know the Quran, and they know the benefit of the Quran, but on purpose, they neglect it. On purpose, they ignore it. They don't care about the Quran. But subhanAllah, how much you're going to be sad in the judgment day? When Allah Azza wa Jalla called the people and told them, as Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned that in the hadith, Allah Azza wa Jalla, he gave the people the memorized Quran and told them, come and read. Wartaqi. Go over and over, go above each level of the Jannah. Every ayah, you got a level for you in the Jannah. So imagine when you see people, they start to read the Quran, and from same level like you, both of you, you enter the Jannah on the same level, but after he start to read the Quran, Allah Azza wa Jalla will take him according to how many ayah he memorized. He memorized 100 ayah, you go 100 level above. You memorize 200 ayah, you go above 200 level. You memorize more, you go above. And the people, they ignore the Quran. And Muhammad SAW said in every ayah, in every letter of the Quran, and he said, I'm not saying alif, lam, mim, ayah, or a letter. It's alif letter and lam letter and mim letter. Every letter, you get 10 hasana of that. And the hasanat, when you get it, when you get this hasanat, it takes the sayyi'at away to clean your book. Inna al-hasanati yudhibna al-sayyi'at. Every time you get more hasanat, takes some bad deed away. So your book always clean. The Quran, clean your book in the dunya. Make you happy in the hereafter. If you let your kids memorize the Quran, your kids are going to come in front of Allah, then after he read the Quran, he's going to let you wear the crown. Everybody will know that's the father. He worked hard to let his son memorize the Quran. But very important, my brothers and sisters, you can let your child memorize the Quran like a CD. You know the CD or the USB? Without understanding the Quran, is like he's reading Chinese book. It's like reading any other language. Like Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when Aisha, she been asked about him, how is Muhammad? Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, she said, كَانَ قُرْآنًا يَمْشِي عَلَى الْأَرْضِ. He was Quran walking. So every action Allah Azza wa Jalla tell him in the Quran, he is to practice it in his life. He said, Umar ibn Khattab, he take long time to memorize Surah Al-Baqarah, to memorize ayah by ayah, and to make the action of the ayah before he memorize the other ayah. So it's not only to let your child just be worried about he memorize the Quran, but he doesn't follow the Quran. He memorized the Quran but doesn't understand the Quran. You must make your best effort to let your son understand the Quran and follow the Quran, do the action of the Quran. Because in the judgment day, my brother, we don't want to be from the people the neglecting the Quran. Otherwise, wallahi, they're going to be very sad. One of the saddest things, people, they go to the hellfire. How much is they going to feel? When Allah Azza wa Jal, He ordered the angels to take some people to the hellfire, to ask Allah Azza to protect us from the hellfire. But there is a sadness. There is some people, they're going to feel sorry, not following the way of Allah Azza wa Jal to come to this situation. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَلَوْ تَرَىٰ إِذْ وُقِفُوا عَلَى النَّارِ فَقَالُوا يَا لَيْتَنَا نُرَدُّ. We wish people, they're going to be standing in front of the hellfire. They're going to the hellfire. They wish to come back again to the dunya. يَا لَيْتَنَا نُرَدُّ وَلَا نُكَذِّبُ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّنَا. We wish to come back again to the dunya, and we never deny the Quran, we never deny the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we never deny the sunnah, we never deny the following of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. People, they will wish to come back again to dunya to win, when they are just opposite the hellfire. That's why Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, nobody will enter the Jannah until he go to see his place in the hellfire first. And then Allah Azza wa Jalla will take him to the Jannah. Just to know the blessing of Allah Azza wa Jalla for you. To know how much Allah is going to make you happy. He's going to take you there, and the angel is going to tell you, that's your place if you disobey Allah in the dunya. And no one will enter the hellfire before he go to see his place in Jannah. And the angel tell him, that's your place if you obey Allah Azza wa Jalla. So imagine how much people, they will be sad. He went to see the Jannah. And that was my place if I just been patient for the ta'ah of Allah, for obeying Allah Azza wa Jal, for very short time. When Allah Azza wa Jal asked the people, how long you been in the dunya? They will say, day or part of the day. We don't know. Fas'al al-'adin, ask the people they used to count the days, because these people they used to count Salat Fajr. I'm waiting for Fajr, I'm waiting for Dhuhr, I'm waiting for Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and then I'm waiting for another Fajr, and then Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib, Isha, and then Fajr. These people, they used to follow day by day, but some other people, Allah mentioned them, they live like an'am, like the animals. Doesn't care, they wake up in the morning, think about what breakfast they're going to eat, what lunch, what dinner, where we're going to go enjoy ourselves. The second day, what breakfast, what lunch, what, the same thing. But the believer, he counted the days according to his iman to Allah Azza wa Jal. So these people, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, they will go to the heaven first. They will see the place in the heaven, and the angel will tell them, that's your place if you obey Allah Azza wa Jal. But let's go back to your real place. Let's go back to the hellfire. So how much people are going to be sad because they did obey Allah Azza wa Jal in the dunya. When the people, they will be in the hellfire, they will start call the people of Jannah, they will call them. You see how much people are going to feel sad? People of Jannah, they will call them, they're going to say, وَنَادَ أَصْحَابُ الْجَنَّةِ أَصْحَابُ النَّارِ. The people of Jannah, they're going to call the people of the hellfire. And they will tell them, أَنْ قَدْ وَجَدْنَا مَا وَعَدَنَا رَبُّنَا حَقًّا. We find what Allah has telling us through. Allah tell us, obey me, you will go to Jannah. And we did obey Allah, and we are in Jannah right now. فَهَلْ وَجَدْتُمْ مَا وَعَدَ رَبُّكُمْ حَقًّا. Did you find what Allah promised you? True? If you disobey Him, you're going to be in the hellfire? So the people of Jannah, they're asking this question, and they're going to say, yes. Yes, we did. Yes, we used to know in the dunya, if we disobey Allah, our place in the hellfire. But we take it as a joke. We didn't take it serious. But now when the people of the heaven calling them, did you find what Allah Azza wa Jal has promised you, has telling you true? Yes, we did. Yes, we did. فَأَذَّنَ مُؤَذِّرٌ. Some angel call. Allah Azza said, بَيْنَهُمْ أَلَّعْنَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَى الظَّالِمِينَ. Allah caused the people disbelieve in Him in this dunya. So imagine when the people, they already in the hellfire. And they already saw the places in the heaven, and they've been taken to the hellfire. And the people of heaven calling them to tell them, Alhamdulillah, we are very happy. We're in the Jannah. They already saw the Jannah. We're in the Jannah. Alhamdulillah, we're very happy. Did you also find what Allah tells you is going to happen? Yes. We did find the hellfire. We did find how hard the hellfire. So before we get to that, Muslims should think quickly. Also Allah Azza wa Jalla, He's telling us, when the person died, and he never followed the way of Allah Azza wa Jalla, what is gonna wish? Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِنَّا أَنْذَرْنَاكُمْ عَذَابًا قَرِيبًا. The non-believer, what they're gonna meet, what we're gonna see in the judgment day, they will wish something. And inshallah we're gonna talk about the wishes in the Quran. إِنَّا أَنْذَرْنَاكُمْ عَذَابًا قَرِيبًا. يَوْمَ يَنْظُرُ الْمَرْءُ مَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاهُ وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ يَا لَيْتَنِي كُنْتُ تُرَابًا. Allah Jal has warned you. And this, Allah Jal said in the Quran, عَذَابًا قَرِيبًا, very close. Our life is 100 years even, is not even a second by Allah Azza wa Jal. For the judgment day, 100 years, not even 2 minutes. So, your life is very close to Allah, to be in front of Him. إِنَّا أَنْذَرْنَاكُمْ عَذَابًا قَرِيبًا, very close punishment. يَوْمَ يَنْظُرُ الْمَرْءُ مَا قَدَّمَتْ يَدَاهُ. Everyone will see what he done in this dunya, good and bad. وَيَقُولُ الْكَافِرُ, and the non-believer will say, I wish if I am dust. I wish if I did been created. We're talking about Umar ibn Khattab and Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. Abu Bakr, he said, I wish if I am branch of tree. That's it. He will get old, they break him, they put him in a fire, doesn't feel anything. Umar ibn Khattab, he said, if I heard somebody calling everybody in Jannah except one, I'll think it's me. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud used to say, Ya Allah, I am here, I wish to die, and you never send me back again. That's the Muslim, the believer, the true believer. So the non-believer, he will wish in this day to be dust. Because for what he done in this dunya. So what he did in this dunya, it will make you either happy or not happy. So that's also another people, they're going to be in the judgment day. Very sad. And even they will wish Allah Azza wa Jalla to make them dust. Another people also, my brother and sisters, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned them in the Quran. Allah said, فَعْبُدُوا مَا شِئْتُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ. Worship whatever you want beside Allah Azza wa Jalla. In this dunya, Allah Azza wa Jalla give you the choice. Do whatever you want. But the consequences after that, there is a judgment day. So Allah Azza wa Jalla said, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ, the losers, the people, they will lose everything. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned them in the Quran, الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمْ, the people, they will lose themselves and the family as well. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to ask you about your family. Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to ask you about your wife. Allah Azza wa Jalla will ask you about your children. Allah Azza wa Jalla will ask you about your daughters. Did you raise her in Islam? And she's to know Allah Azza wa Jalla, and she's to wear hijab to practice. When she grow up, it's going to be normal for her, inshallah. Allah Azza wa Jalla is going to ask you about your child. Is to bring him to the masjid. You connect him to the masjid of Allah Azza wa Jalla. إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, to make him a true believer, to come to fill up the masjid of Allah Azza wa Jal. Did you used to get your son to the masjid? Or you ignore them, you don't care about them. It doesn't matter if my son wanted to come or not. It doesn't matter if my wife, she wanted to wear hijab or not. I'm not saying force. No one allow to force anyone for the ibadah. It's forbidden in Islam. You have to talk. You have to get the evidence. You have to let her love. You have to change her heart. So she can, inshallah, act in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. Your children must love the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. You cannot force them. It's forbidden in Islam. But that's why we said, from the early age, if you start with them, it will be easy for you, inshallah. So Allah Azza wa Jal tell us about the people, they will lose everything. خسروا أنفسهم وأهلهم يوم القيامة على ذلك هو الخسران المبين. Isn't it the great loss? If you lost your family and yourself, a great loss. Allah Azza asking us this question. Isn't this a great loss? Yes, wallahi. If the person loses himself, he's not following the way of Allah Azza wa Jal, he lost his wife, his kids, that's a great loss. That's a big loss in your life. Also Allah Azza wa Jal is talking about the ظالمين, the people they meet unjust in the dunya. And even tell us expression, يوم يعض الظالم على يديه. The one is gonna feel very sorry. الظالم, the one he's been unjust to somebody else. يقول, what is gonna say in this time? يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. I wish if I follow the way of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I wish if I follow the way of my prophet. I wish if I didn't be unjust to anybody. يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا. And also the people they're gonna be sorry in this day, the people they would choose a wrong friend instead of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, instead of Islam. يقول يا ليتني اتخذت مع الرسول سبيلا يا ويلتا. He knows الويل, جهنم is for me. Why? يا ليتني لم اتخذ فلانا خليلا. I wish if I didn't have this friend. Why? What's wrong with this friend? لقد أضلني عن الذكر. He misguided me from the way of Allah عز وجل, from Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. That's why Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم still us. المرء على دين خليله فلينظر أحدكم من يخالل. Every friend, he follow his friend way. Subhanallah, you can't talk to your son or your daughter too much. And the ulama of psychology said, your children can take from you as parents and teacher and sheikh only about 40% from his life. And you have to work hard to deliver this 40% to him. But his friend can change him with 60% in a second. 60%. Kids sitting with each other, talking, they understand each other. Let's do this, we'll do it, finish. My father is old-fashioned. Don't worry about him. My mom, she's very old-fashioned. Different life, different. We're in Australia. My mom doesn't understand that. My dad doesn't understand that. They think we're coming from overseas like them. No, we are not. So the friend, they have too much influence for your son and your daughter. If your friend, if your son's friend is not on the way of Allah Azza wa Jal, they will change them as well to the bad way. So be careful. Choose for your children their friend as well. Choose the right friend for them. That's why we always said, bring them to the masjid so they can have a good friend, inshallah. Otherwise, if they go with a wrong friend, you don't know where they're going to end. And that's why the people, they're going to be sorry in this day. They would say, we wish we didn't take this friend because he misguided us from the way of Allah, from the way of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and now they are feeling very sorry. Another people, the people, they're going to be stingy in the dunya. They don't want to spend for sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. And they know very well, they will leave everything behind. They're not taking any things. They're not taking the cars with them. They're not taking the houses with them. They're not taking the bank account with them. Nobody take his checkbook in the graveyard so he can't send the checks to somebody. Nobody will take his mobile with him to the grave and he can't watch the Facebook. It's finished. Everything is done. You're going to be in this place alone with your good deed or your bad deed. But some people, in the time of death, they will wish not to die. Why? They wanted to fix something? They wanted to make more money? They wanted to... No, wallahi. Allah said in the Quran, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولُ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Before death, when death comes, it's finished, I'm dying. Everyone, if even is going to Jannah, he will wish, Ya Allah, can you delay me? Why? What you want? I wanted to give sadaqah. That's it. I wanted to delay my death time one day. Only one day. Look how long we live. Only one day, Ya Allah. I want only one day. What you want? I wanted to give sadaqah. فأصدق أكون من الصالحين. And I wanted to be a good person. One day only. But of course, when the death comes, no delay. It's finished. When the time comes, but people, they will feel very sorry if they die and they do something for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. صدقة جارية. Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us, إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. If the person died, son of Adam, he died, all his deeds will be cut off except three things. One of them, صدقة جارية, ongoing charity. Something you give it for sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Uthman ibn Affan, 1400 years ago, He buy well. Until now, there is account in Saudi Arabia under the name of Osman ibn Affan. It's waqf until now. They bought so many land around it and they planted and they give it to the sake of Allah, they sell it and they get the money. They put it in account of Osman ibn Affan and then send it to the needy, whatever. Osman ibn Affan's account is still now existing. So he makes sadaqah jariyah for the Muslims this time. Allah accepted it from him and he let his sadaqah jariyah until this time. Can you believe it? He still have account in Saudi Arabia right now. And this account is still given for the needy. And he still own, Osman ibn Affan is still own this well and all the land around it. So because Allah Ajal, he accept his donation. Allah Ajal, he accept his sadaqah. And he let it ongoing charity. And it doesn't matter you have to do like Uthman, because if Allah Ajal knows what you do, Allah has given us example with Uthman's sadaqah. That's why Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he asked them to give sadaqah, Uthman, he give and he give again, like when you come to give sadaqah. We ask the brothers, brother, please, inshallah, we need to collect some money for somebody. So the brother, you come, alhamdulillah, give 1,000 or 2 or 3 or 5. And you come again to ask him, brother, inshallah, we need another money because brother in different places or different masjid. So the brother, he come with 3,000. First time 5, now 3. And then you ask him, brother, again, so he bring $1,000. And then you ask him, bring $100. And then you ask him, bring $10 every time. That's enough. You're taking all my money. But Uthman ibn Affan, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, is asking once. He give 100,000. So Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked him again. But Uthman, he came again with another 100,000. Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't ask him again. He came again with another 100,000. Until he make it 800,000. And he give a lot of things. So Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he used to look at the money, like flipping the money like that, and said, مَا دَرَّ عُثْمَانَ مَا فَعَلَ بَعْدَ الْيَوْمِ. If Uthman did anything bad, nothing would harm him. He finished. He do it for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's why Allah Azza wa Jal accept his sadaqah and they make it waqf till now for the Muslims until this day, 1,400 years ago. So some people, they will wish to come back again to the dunya to give sadaqah, but if the time is late, it's finished. So my brother, inshallah, we still have some more things, inshallah, we're going to talk about. The Muslim should to be, inshallah, fixing his future in the hereafter to be happy, not to be sad. And the Quran is telling us, what can make you sad? If you do opposite, you will be happy, inshallah. So the smart person, he take from the Quran the way to be happy, not the way to be sad. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us happy in this dunya and the hereafter, inshallah. Inshallah, next week we'll continue with the value of the Quran with some more things about how to make yourself, inshallah, and your kids and your wife and your family happy in the hereafter, inshallah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت استغفرك ونتوب إليك. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. سبحان ربك رب العزة.